All right, guys, we're back in my garage for another episode of the B58 Digest. If you're new to the channel, I use these videos to help keep you updated on the latest developments in the B58 community. So if that's something that you're interested in, be sure to subscribe to the channel. There will be a lot more of these videos coming out in the future. So today we're going to talk about the next generation of the B58, and this is something that we speculated about a little bit in the past in other videos, and now we finally got some firm news on what we can expect to see with the new engine that's going to be coming out. And the way that this was revealed to us is BMW posted up a press release for the updates to their X7 as well as the 7 Series. And with these LCI models, they usually implement a lot of their new technologies because those are the BMW flagship vehicles. So you'll see all of the new interior technologies and features as well as any new engine technology that they plan on putting out in the fleet. So in this case, it was no different. They're going to have a new twin turbo V8 called the S68, as well as a new version of the B58. And they gave us a little bit of insight on what we can expect to see in this new version of the B58. Now, I know most of you guys watching this already realize that there are several versions of the B58 out there. So just kind of stick with me here. I know this can get kind of confusing, but we're going to go over what we have. So, of course, we have the first generation of the B58 that came out back in 2015 and 2016. And then eventually BMW released a technical update to the B58 that you can call the TU1. They had a two-port version that came out in models like the 2020 Supra. And then eventually a six-port version came to vehicles like the M340i and M440i. And eventually, of course, it trickled back into the Supra as well. Now, what some people don't realize is that two-port version is still being used in some of the bigger vehicles. So that being the X7 and the current 7 Series. And even though it's still a TU engine, it is slightly different than the six-port versions that most people are more interested in now. It tends to have higher flowing cylinder heads. It also tends to hold a little bit more power due to its lower compression ratio. However, unfortunately, they are continuing with this two-port version in the new X7 and the new 7 Series. I'm not really sure if there's going to be a new six-port version, but I do anticipate there will be. And it'll probably be in the same vehicles like the LCI version of the M340i, and maybe in a year or so we'll see that in the Supra as well. But this information is still pretty insightful and gives us a good insight on what we can see in future engines. So I'll go ahead and link the press release down below in the description that kind of details everything that they're going to be putting into the car. But the big thing is, of course, it has more power as well as better efficiency and better emissions. So they're bumping up the power from 335 to 375 horsepower. That's a lot closer to the power figures of the six-port version. So I'm hoping if they do release a six-port version of this TU2 engine, it's maybe even closer to 400, if not over 400 horsepower. And then they have a whole slew of things that they're doing to help improve efficiency. So this is going to be another model with the 48-volt mild hybrid technology that helps it be a lot more efficient as well as give it a little bit of a bump in torque, depending on the circumstances. They have a new Vano system being implemented that's all controlled electronically. So in older BMW engines, it's all controlled by oil pressure in that cam gear. And now there's going to be an electronic control behind that to help give it faster response as well as more adjustability. They're also going to introduce Valvetronic onto the exhaust side. So it basically says that there's a rocker that can restrict the exhaust gas flow coming out of the cylinder head. And this helps optimize your braking. So when you come off the throttle, it'll help the batteries kind of recharge more quickly and just give you a better opportunity to have, again, more efficiency and more torque. They're also going to be using the Miller cycle on this engine, which is pretty unique. That basically gives it a variable compression ratio, for lack of better terms. So again, a more efficient system. And then the exhaust manifold, again, is integrated into the cylinder head. So that's where we will have the two-port cylinder head option in these cars. Now, the big news that everybody's talking about is it's also going to come with provisions for port injection. And I think some of us saw this coming because with the S58 intake manifold, it already has the bosses kind of set up so that they can implement port injection. And a lot of us anticipated that the S58TU will come with port injection whenever that comes out in the next maybe 2 or 3 years. So it looks like they're also implementing that on the B58. Primarily, they're saying that this is to reduce carbon buildup and help improve emissions, just like all the other engines like, you know, the RS3 and TTRS that come with port injection. The OEM implements it for the same reason. But we know from an aftermarket standpoint that that also means You can simply upgrade injectors, maybe upgrade your low pressure fuel pump if needed, and support a lot more power. So I'm curious to see how this will look once it's all implemented. I'm guessing it'll look just like the S58, so six injectors mounted on top of the intake manifold that we can simply swap out and install larger injectors to support more power, and all of it will be controlled by the DME. And speaking of the DME, a lot of people have asked me if they think that this will mean that the cars will be easier to unlock because the port injection makes it easier to tune, or will it have like a brand new DME that will need another 5 years or whatever to unlock? And I don't really think either of those are the case. I'm expecting it to come with the same DMEs that we've seen being used in all the B58, S58 vehicles lately. So I expect that to have the same timing to be unlocked. And if we're lucky and the DMEs do get unlocked this year, maybe we'll see some six-port versions come to, you know, the Supra and the M340i and some of these other models next year that can fully take advantage of this, and we'll really see these cars really perform. So yeah, I think that pretty much sums up everything. Again, the link down in the description is the official BMW press release. It actually was posted back in like mid-April, so it kind of flew under the radar for most of us, but I saw a couple articles share this information, and before I made this video, I just wanted to make sure I got the information straight from BMW. So that's why it took me a little while to make this video, but hopefully this answers all of your questions. And yeah, I think that's it. So thank you guys for watching, and I hope this helps. And if you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below. Do-do-do.